Hey Matterporters, thanks for joining me. In this customization video, I want to talk to you about Mattertags and how crucial and important they are to your models. Mattertags are a way for you to inform your visitors by adding things like descriptions, images, PDF documents, even entire models can be embedded into a Mattertag. You can also add links to other websites, forms, shopping carts, just about anything, including a deep link into another model, which is a really great way of linking between two models. How to generate a deep link from your model is something I spoke about in another video, to which I will link in the description below. So let's go ahead and see how you can add these Mattertags to your models. I'll go into Edit. Right here is the Mattertags tool, and I just click on this to expand the drawer. Like many other tools, I can collapse or expand this drawer. And right up here is the list of floors that I have in this model. You can see that currently I have 0 Mattertags on the first floor. Like all the other tools that show me the floors, I can use the 3-dot menu here to rename this floor. I'll skip that for now and just come right down here and press the Add Mattertag button. When I do that, you can see that a Mattertag is going around and following my cursor, and around the Mattertag is a kind of a bright circle. This circle is actually showing me the 3D mesh or geometry that's underneath the 2D panorama that I'm looking at. I can click and drag if I don't want to place the Mattertag right over here, and let me come right over here and just put a tag right there. So I'll just click once and the tag sticks to this surface. And up comes the tag where I can add a title and a description. In this case, I'll just leave the description blank, but down here you can see are all my options for customizing this Mattertag. I can change the color of the Mattertag right here. I can change the stem length right here. I can even specify don't show me the stem at all. I can add a description down here. Highlight the words that I want to be the link and just click the Add Link button right here. And here I can place a link to the technical specs on the web page or maybe a PDF document that are available on the manufacturer's website. Just a heads up, if you are going to add links to your Mattertags, you are limited to a maximum of 5 links in each Mattertag. I'll just click the Close button. And here I can include media. So you can embed assets such as images, PDF documents, and videos, but you're not going to be able to embed entire websites into a Mattertag. Also in the description below, I have linked to Embedly's website where they list all the providers that they support. So if you're wondering if something can be embedded into your Mattertag, go ahead and check out that link. Once you're done with that, I'll just click Close and hit Done. Now you can see up here, the title of my Mattertag is listed. And if I'm located somewhere else and I want to zip towards this Mattertag, I can just click on it and it'll take me right to the Mattertag and open it up. Now what I can do is press the pencil icon to further edit this Mattertag or the trash can icon to delete the Mattertag. I can also do the same thing up here in the 3-dot menu. If I click here, I can press edit or delete. And that's all there is to it, really. Adding and editing your Mattertags is super simple and incredibly powerful. You can add so much more information to your models to enhance your visitor's experience. I hope this information was helpful, and we'll see you in the next video.